Hello everyone and welcome to today's video. This is a big one compared to my first video, which is my last video actually. And today I'll be showing you all bits and pieces and all parts of my camera collection that I've been doing for around 4 to 5 years now. It's taken a while and I'm going to be going it through chronological order between the oldest camera in the collection to the newest camera. To start off, we're going to be showing you guys the Enzyme Celfix 420 developed in the 1940s. At the time, these recording cameras were introduced as they folded well and easy to the pocket, and they used compact film, which was 120 film, which is commonly known today as the Ilford P5 Plus using ISO 400. And these cameras were very popular at the time. As you can see, they pop in and out of the camera using accordion, which are bellows, which fold in and out. It's a very beautiful camera. It's the oldest in the collection. It actually happens to be my first vintage and older camera. The next camera that I'll be showing you guys have been my last video. If you've watched the last video, you know a lot about it. It's the Leica 3C. The Leica 3C was built between the 1940s to 1951. And this camera is well known, very famous. It's with a spin of the knob, shutter, very famous as well. Leica is the best brand in the world for cameras. Very significant in history of cameras and compact cameras. Another gadget I like to show, I didn't mention in my last video, was this optic. So for range finders, which is the FED 2 and the Leica 3C, what people need to understand is that what you're looking through the viewfinder is not what you see through the lens. So that's why this optic is built to put right on top of the camera. It's representing basically the lens, depending on what kind of lens you have. Since on the FED 2, I have an f2.8 lens, I have to roll it all the way to f2.8 so I can, that's what I see. And that's what's put on top, and same for the Leica lens. Second camera, also already shown in the last video, is the FED 2. This is the Russian model of the Leica 3C built in 1957. And the FED 2 is a great camera, although it's trying to copy what the Germans did with the Leica 3C and the Leica M series later on. The FED 2 has the same sort of system on the top where you spin to set your film, then you set exposure, then you can shoot the shutter as well as set your aperture speed. In 1957, this is a very interesting camera, which may seem strange to people who are not used to using film cameras before and haven't seen them. This is what's called a twin lens reflex camera, which is the first Yashica mat. Which is funny because the Yashica mat is also a Japanese made version of the original twin lens reflex camera of the Rolleiflex. And what's interesting about this is that the viewfinder is on waist height, so you can look down and focus with this knob right here. And the reason why there are two lenses is that one lens is used as a mirror to reflect what you see in the viewfinder, while the other lens is where the photo is actually being taken and bringing in light to the film. On the viewfinder, there are three ways. There's a direct glass where you can see through the lens. There is a little eyepiece to really focus in on what you're shooting. And then there's also this little hole in the middle for faster shutter speeds where you're aiming and trying to get that right shot while panning. This next camera is a very strange, very cool, very original at the time, which is the Polaroid 100 series. This was a very significant camera in history too, because that's what, after a few years, 10-20 years later, it started bringing automatic film, like instant film. This is it. You pull your film out. Yeah, I'll show you. Pull right here after you take a picture, then second part, you pull to get your exposure up. Obviously you have to wait for it to develop for between 1 to 2 minutes, and that's how it works. So you have those two pieces. It's a cool camera overall, takes beautiful pictures, great saturation in the images, especially black and white. There's a lot of detail and lines and curves and facial features as well if you like to shoot portraits. It's very recommended if you can get yourself one. The next camera that I have may seem more common since it's currently being refurbished by this company called the Impossible Project. And they've been refurbishing cameras, they've been selling new film. It's very interesting, very simple setup in this camera. It's simply beautiful. So, the Polaroid One-Step 600 close-up flash. Very interesting camera. It has the shutter, it has a flash shutter, and it has a no flash shutter. You can see on the top, this big flash on top. It has close-up and standard. This is the close-up. It has a little lens up, like you could call it a lens on the top for zooming in and out. And then you have the standard from 4 feet to infinity. By infinity, they mean to the horizon or how far you want to take your picture. So I'll give an example with film. Again, there's no focus necessarily unless on distance, but for this case, it comes straight out from the bottom.
So guys, here's how the photo turned out. I just wanted to say that this is the black and white 2.0 film that Impossible released just recently, the rendition of the first 1.0 black and white film. And there are a lot of great, beautiful textures between the dark blacks and the light whites. I really love how they bring that out in the photo.
The next camera will have to be one of my favorite cameras in this collection, only for this reason. First of all, it is the Canon AE-1. The Canon AE-1 is an SLR, different from these rangefinders. SLRs have a vertical flap of glass that reflects onto the film, while rangefinders move horizontally and have leave a little flap open to put light onto the film. It's one of the best cameras at the time. It really revolutionized SLRs and how photojournalists started using and taking shots, fast shots. It uses 35mm film and 36 exposures on each shot. It's also very simple. What's cool about this camera is now when you pull the shutter halfway down, it has an automatic light meter. And a light meter basically tells you what aperture you have. So instead of guessing it yourself with the eye, you basically hold halfway down. On the right side of the viewfinder, it will show you what aperture, set it on the lens, set your shutter speed, and you take the shot. So in this case, I'll just show you how it looks compared to the rangefinders. Set it up, focus, take shot, and then you wind it back like that. This camera definitely has way more accessories compared to other cameras since it's my dad's. It was the only one. He got a lot of accessories at the time, and he got a lot of things. So the first lens, Sigma 28-70, f1.3, which is pretty impressive. That's a great lens. Very low f-stop, which is good for getting in more light into your shots. It's really good. My dad told me this was his favorite lens only because at the time, 28mm was the widest you could get. The second lens is a 75 to 200mm. Great for zoom if you need it. I don't use it that much because it's not common for zoom. I like walking on the streets and just taking shots from there. What's said on the Canon AE-1 itself is the 50mm SLR. Another accessory for the Canon AE-1 that I have is the Vivitar 550FD, and this is a great flash if you need it. The last camera in the collection was a gift from a friend. He got it from like some market in the States one summer and gave it to me. And this, although it doesn't work sadly, this is a Konica C35MF. This is around the 1982 actually. And this is when cameras started getting way smaller. Everything was autofocus, everything was auto exposure, everything was auto shutter speed and aperture, and they all did it themselves. And it's a pretty neat camera. It's really like 80s design. I couldn't be able to use it, but it's a cool thing to put on your wall just because it looks so retro and pretty cool. So guys, thank you so much for watching. As you can see, it's a pretty wide, extensive camera collection. I hope to bring it even further in the future. If you like this video, please leave a like down below. And if you'd like to subscribe and like this content, just also hit subscribe down below. Thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video and have a nice day.